Welcome, welcome to this new year deep relaxation practice. My name is Laure and I am delighted to be your guide as you take this time to celebrate the new year that is starting. I want to wish you a wonderful new year. May it bring you what it is that you are longing for. May your heartfelt wishes become reality. And so to start off the year, I'd like to offer a practice to help you build an intention, whether it is for this full year or maybe at least part of this year. An intention, or sankalpa in Sanskrit, is much different than a resolution. A resolution demands that we push ourselves, that we replace something with something better, something more, maybe something less. A resolution is a new year, new you type of mindset that emanates from an outside view on yourself without regards for who you truly are inside or what it is that you really need. And that is why it often fails. And that is why it can possibly fail to begin with, because it isn't genuine and authentic. And therefore it is not necessarily sustainable. An intention, on the other hand, is a path to reveal who you truly are, to shine your true self. An intention comes from an inner reflection, a state of introspection that leads you closer to who you are, leads you to befriend yourself. It is a new year, true you mindset that is driven by compassion, hence making any consideration of success or failure irrelevant. And so in this class, we'll spend some time building your intention, your sankalpa, and then we'll spend some more time sealing it within so that it can bloom during and after the practice for however long you'd like to work with your intention or until it realizes, whichever comes first. So you can start settling down for the relaxation. We won't be doing any movement today. If you have a preferred position for your practice, you can go ahead and get set. Use as many pillows, blankets, accessories to be comfortable and warm throughout the class. And if you don't have a preferred position, or if you maybe want to explore another option today, I'll walk you through the traditional posture, which is shavasana, lying down on your back. So as you lay down, I suggest that you place a small pillow under your head so that the skin of your scalp won't get sore. We will remain in the same position for the rest of this class. So do with what you have at home, but as possible, find a pillow that isn't too high so that your chin doesn't tuck in towards your chest, creating an overextension in your cervical spine. But also a pillow that isn't too low so that your chin doesn't point up towards the ceiling, creating an overarching in your cervical spine. I also suggest placing another pillow, or maybe a folded blanket or a bolster if you have at home, under your knees. This will help you keep a natural bend in your knees, preventing any discomfort, any cramping in your legs, but also alleviating some tensions in your low back as well. And you can keep your feet at hip-width distance apart if it is comfortable to you. Let your feet naturally dangle wherever they are most comfortable. And if you prefer to have your legs crossed, that's fine. Be mindful that during the process of deep relaxation, your body becomes more sensitive. Hence, if you have your legs crossed, it can be useful to place another pillow in between so that that position won't become uncomfortable over time. I also suggest throwing a blanket over your body. During the process of deep relaxation, your body temperature will drop. Your body enters a state of deep stillness as if it were asleep. And so the blanket can help you remain warm during the class. And you can place your arms alongside your body, palms facing up for a creative experience. Palms facing down for a grounding experience. You can also rest your hands over your belly. This is very soothing for the nervous system. And whichever option you choose, make sure that your hands are either fully under the blanket or fully outside of the blanket. Our hands and feet, for that matter, are very important in helping us regulate our body temperature. So if the blanket is halfway over your hands or your feet, this will send some mixed messages and you will have a harder time regulate your body temperature during the class. If you are wearing glasses, heavy piece of jewelry, maybe a watch, something in your hair or a belt, I suggest that you put these items aside. There again, during deep relaxation, the body becomes more sensitive and those items can become uncomfortably heavy. So take your time, get set. This is not the most exciting part of class, but it is a crucial step. The way that you set yourself up will help you enter deeper into the practice. So as you settle, make any little adjustment, scratch an itch, move that pillow slightly, the little things that become apparent now. And you can, of course, move at any point in time during class. This is time that you're taking for yourself, so do what best serves you. And this is true for everything that I say. My guidance is an invitation, and if it resonates with you, you're welcome to follow it. But if it doesn't, you're also welcome to leave it aside. Give yourself permission to adjust my cues. They don't resonate with you, change them to something that is better suited for your practice today. And you can even take a break and join back when it feels more appropriate. And if you drift off to sleep, that's okay. You won't be missing out. Your body is still listening as you sleep. Whenever you feel that it is adequate, you can come back to my guidance and join back the class. You can close your eyes at any time. And if closing your eyes isn't comfortable today, you can soften your gaze. Gently invite your eyes to stillness. Staring at a steady focus point in front of you. Take a moment to arrive. You've just settled down physically, so take a moment to settle down mentally as well. Transition into this relaxation. Hear the sounds around you, within your space. Let them guide you to connect with your environment, your space here and now. You're right here at this very moment. You have nowhere else to be, nothing else to do. No one else to attend to but yourself. You have arrived to your practice. this deep relaxation practice that you intended to take. And you may have thoughts and distractions running through your mind. This is normal. Don't beat yourself up. Your brain needs some time, some mindful, deliberate effort to shift away from the prior activities of your day. So when you catch yourself getting lost in thoughts, as your mind wanders off in distractions, intentionally take a deep breath in through your nose. Picture these thoughts, these distractions as clouds, small or big, light or dark, fluffy or dense. And as you breathe out through your mouth, push these clouds away with your out-breath. Repeat this as many times as you need. Watch these clouds of thoughts and distractions fly away in the distance. Let them be carried away by your out-breath. And once you feel that you've unloaded yourself of what you won't need for this class, you can let your breath settle. Let it find its own natural rhythm. Your body breathing at its own pace. And if it is comfortable to you today, connect with your breath as it passes by your heart center, that space in the middle of your chest, under your breastbone, deep inside your chest cavity. For a moment, being present with the energy, the vibration of your breath at the space of your heart. Your heart center is the seat of your inner wisdom. So as you begin to craft your intention, take a moment to intentionally listen to the messages coming from that space deep within your chest cavity. Whether they are worded or not, they may come as feelings, sensations, images, symbols, intuitions, or any other way. Take a moment to observe what arises as you connect with your own heart center. It may be subtle, unclear even, and that's okay. Keep observing for now. So as you listen to your own inner wisdom, start to try to put this message into words. In the yogic tradition, building an intention or your sankalpa is a crucial part of the practice. It is what gives your practice meaning, purpose, motivation. Your intention is an answer to your heartfelt desire, your heartfelt longing. Take a moment, find a few words that will capture the essence of your intention, and you can play with different sentences, different phrasings. In the yogic tradition, the guideline is to word your intention in the present tense as if it were already your lived reality. This is a very important part of your sankalpa, as you can, avoiding any negative or passive phrasing. You are the actor of your life, and your intention should reflect that. And if nothing clear comes up, that's okay. That may be a message in and of itself. As best you can, stay connected with your heart's wisdom. If it becomes fleeting, intentionally reconnect with that space deep within your chest cavity. Let it help you refine your message, your intention. In the yogic tradition, the guideline is to stay away as you can from any material or superficial craving. For example, winning the lottery, looking like this or that. It is normal to have those cravings given the societies that we've built for ourselves. But in this exercise, you have an opportunity to be authentic, to be honest with yourself. So, as you look inside yourself, what is it that you truly need in order to be happy? What is it that you really long for? Be open to the answer that arises. It is normal to want a clear, definite, everything-proof message, but it may not be the case. And it may also take several iterations, several versions for you to find your intention, maybe even several classes. And if you feel confused, maybe frustrated even, if your mind starts to think frantically, it's okay. Take a step back. Reconnect with your breath once more. Staying with your breath as it passes by your heart center. There is no pressure to find the perfect intention. And maybe that is part of your message. Take a few more moments now to finalize your intention for today. Again, it doesn't have to be the final version. It doesn't have to be perfect. And it doesn't come with any strings attached either. Quite the opposite, actually. It will likely evolve and change as you practice with it. But for now, whichever intention you've crafted so far, let it resonate within you as you repeat it to yourself. repeating it as if it were already your lived reality. Genuinely repeating your intention until it permeates every cell of your body, until it feels like it has become your lived reality. And notice what it feels like to live in the reality of your intention already realized. And you can now let your intention vanish from your conscious mind. Rest assured that it will remain with you throughout this class. Now that you've planted the seed, the essence of your sankalpa deep within you, we'll take some time in the rest of class to install it further. And for now, I will guide you through a body awareness exercise. So as I name different parts of the body, bring your awareness to that part in your body. There is no need to move, and if any part of this exercise doesn't feel right, if any part of this exercise is not comfortable, leave it aside. Respect your own boundaries. It is part of the practice. So starting at the tip of your right thumb, place your awareness at the tip of your right thumb. Feel every cell at the tip of your right thumb, every cell invigorated, pulsating with the felt reality of your intention already realized. Onto the tip of your right index finger, your right middle finger, your right ring finger, to the tip of your right pinky. Every cell of your right fingers enlivened by the essence of your intention. That essence trickling into the palm of your right hand, the top of your hand, to your right wrist, your right forearm, your right elbow, your right upper arm, and your right shoulder. The essence of your intention already realized in every cell of your right arm. Trickling along your right collarbone to the little valley between your collarbones and down into your heart center. Hopping over to the tip of your left thumb, place your awareness in the tip of your left thumb. Feel every cell of your left thumb enlivened by the essence of your intention already realized. Into the tip of your left index finger, your left middle finger, your left ring finger, and your left pinky. Every cell of your left fingers invigorated by the vibration of your intention. Trickling into the palm of your left hand, the top of your hand, your left wrist, your left forearm, your left elbow, your left upper arm and into your left shoulder. Feel the essence of your intention already realized in every cell of your left arm. Trickling along your left collarbone to the little valley between your collarbones and down into your heart center once again. The essence of your intention spreading from your heart center to the right side of your chest, the right side of your rib cage, your right lung, back to your heart center, to the left side of your chest, the left side of your rib cage, your left lung, your physical heart, your whole chest cavity vibrating with the essence of your intention already realized. Going down into your diaphragm, your upper abdomen, into your navel, dipping to your core muscles, your digestive organs, every cell of your abdomen enlivened by the essence of your intention already realized. All the way to your hip bone, onto your right hip, your right thigh, your right knee and kneecap, your right shin, right calf, your right ankle, your right heel, the sole of your right foot, the top of your foot, and into your right toes, your right big toe, your right second toe, your right third toe, your right fourth toe, and your right little toe. Your whole right leg, every cell of your right leg vibrating with your intention already realized. From your toes all the way to your right sit bone. Now hopping over to your left hip, your left thigh, your left knee and kneecap, your left shin, left calf, your left ankle, your left heel, the sole of your left foot, the top of your foot, and your left toes, your left big toe, your left second toe, your left third toe, your left fourth toe, and your left little toe. Your whole left leg, every cell of your left leg vibrating with your intention already realized. From your toes all the way up to your left sit bone. Now place your awareness at your tailbone, at the end of your spine. Feel the essence of your intention at your tailbone. Flowing up your whole spine, reaching every vertebrae of your lumbar spine, every vertebrae of your thoracic spine, all the way to the vertebrae of your cervical spine. Your whole spine, from your tailbone to your neck, vibrating with your intention already realized. That vibration spreading into your whole back, enlivening every cell of your back, from your lower back all the way up through your shoulder blades and into your neck. Your whole back vibrating with the essence of your intention. The essence flowing into the back of your head, every cell of your scalp, the cells of your skull, and into your brain, through the crown of your head, and flowing down into your forehead, at the space between your eyebrows, to your right eye and your right brow, your right temple and your right ear, centering back at the space between your eyebrows, to your left eye and your left brow, your left temple and your left ear, back again at the space between your eyebrows, down the ridge of your nose to the tip of your nose, down the little valley below your nose to your upper lip, your lower lip, your whole mouth, your jaws, your teeth, your tongue, your right cheek, your left cheek, to your chin, down through the center of your throat, to the little valley between your collarbones, and finally back at your heart center once again. Your whole body, feel your whole body, every cell of your body vibrating with the essence of your intention already realized. Trillions of individual cells invigorated by your sankalpa. Trillions of individual cells living the reality of your intention. Trillions of individual cells forming a whole, your whole body, your whole body, your whole body. Will now guide you through opposite sensations in your body, and there again, if my guidance resonates with you, feel free to follow it, but if it doesn't, give yourself permission to leave it aside. So as we begin, notice where in your body you feel light. Maybe under your feet, behind your knees, the skin of your face, wherever in your body you can connect with this feeling of lightness. And see if you can spread that feeling to your whole body feeling light, as if you could float above the floor. And now let go of this feeling of lightness and explore the opposite feeling of heaviness, see if you can find a place in your body where you feel heavily anchored into your support. Maybe your heels, your shoulder blades, the back of your head. Wherever you can connect with the feeling of grounded heaviness in your body. And there again, see if you can spread that feeling to your whole body. Your whole body feeling heavily grounded into your support. And now, if you'd like, explore alternating between these two sensations. Feeling light with your inhales, the lightness of your intention already realized with every inhale, and feeling heavy with your exhales, the heaviness of your intention not achieved yet on your exhale. Do this as best you can. This is a practice. And again, if any part doesn't feel right, leave it aside. This is your practice. You can then let go of these sensations and bring your awareness to the screen of your mind. In Sanskrit, it is called chidakash, and it translates literally into the space of your mind. So connect with that vast, dark space behind your closed eyes. It is where your dreams happen at night. It is where your imagination can express itself. And on that vast screen, picture yourself walking in a forest. It is a deep and dense forest. Trees lined up one after the other so closely, they build a wall of dark brown trunks that obstruct the view. Everywhere you look, you see nothing but trees. The light is dim. It is dark and damp in the forest. The rays of sun barely pierce through the dense canopy of leaves. It rains a chilly obscurity that reaches deep into your bones. As you follow the tiny path that meanders amongst the huge trees, it feels like every twist, every turn brings you deeper into these woods. You feel as if you've lost your way, looking desperately for a clearing, a trail marker, a sign of any sort that would help you find your way out. But the more you walk, the farther the exit seems to be. And suddenly, at yet another turn in the path, you discern in the distance what looks like a little cottage. You run towards it, and soon find yourself in front of a cozy little wood cabin. It looks warm, with smoke coming out of the chimney. There is a soft yellow light that shines through the windows, bringing a sense of comfort to the dark woods. It is so inviting. You decide to step in. As soon as you walk through the door, you're taken by an instant sense of relief. Everything about this cabin is deeply comforting. You feel a strong sense of homecoming, of safety and peace. You can finally rest here, nestled in the comfortable rocking chair, wrapped in a warm and soft blanket in front of the fireplace. You can catch your breath, a moment of respite, a moment when everything else suspends, time holds still while you find the answer to the maze of the forest. And so you do just that. Neatly settled in the rocking chair, wrapped in the soft blanket, the fire warming up the skin of your cheeks. You sit there, listening to the messages of your heart, to your inner wisdom, as it reveals the answers to your deepest longings. Rich of your answers, your intention revealed to you. You're ready to leave the cozy little cottage and hop back into the forest, certain this time that you will find your way. For this cottage is nothing but the space of your heart, your inner wisdom, and you can access it at any time when you feel the need for guidance. And to seal your intention, your sankalpa, as you lived reality once again, repeat it to yourself 3 more times. And then for a short moment now, let your mind be free. Let it find its innate state of stillness. No visualization, no sensation, no exercise. Let it be still. And as this practice now comes to an end, you can choose to turn off your device if you'd like to remain in this silent stillness, this silent relaxation a little bit longer. Otherwise, if your day is not yet over, bring your awareness to the space around you. Reconnect with your environment. Hear the sounds around you. Within your space, or maybe outside of your windows. Notice the light of your space maybe coming through your closed eyelids. Feel the sensation of your body lying on your support. You've been here all along. While your mind was on a little journey, your body was right there, lying on your support in the position that you chose for your practice. Take a moment to reconnect with that sensation of grounding, your body resting upon your support. Right here, in your space, anchored in this present moment. As we begin to awaken the physical body, slowly initiate some tiny movements in your fingers, your toes, maybe touch your fingertips together, thumb to index finger, to middle finger, to ring finger, to your pinky. Feel that sense of contact between your fingertips. Notice the energy that flows into your fingers in order for you to move. And let this energy guide you to bigger movements with your hands, feet, flowing into your whole arms and legs, energy rushing over through your whole body, guiding you to a full body stretch maybe, or maybe you'd prefer to bring your knees to your chest, sway side to side. Any intuitive movement that feels right to bring you back to the here and now, to energize your body. And once you're fully present, if your practice calls for it, you can bring yourself back up to a comfortable seated position. You can wrap yourself in your blanket. Place a pillow under your hips for the comfort of your low back. You can keep your eyes closed for now. And if you want to join me in closing class today, you can bring your hands to your heart. May your intention guide you to reveal your true self this year. Thank you. Thank you so much for your presence in this class. And most of all, thank you for your commitment to yourself. I look forward to continuing this journey with you this year. Namaste.